Sairam students and welcome to this session. Today we will be doing a chapter from the Moments, that is chapter 5, The Happy Prince, written by Oscar Wilde. So first let's begin with the with knowing something about the author. Oscar Wilde Wilde was an Irish poet and playwright. After writing in different forms throughout the 1880s, the early 1890s saw him become one of the most popular playwrights in London. His notable works include The Picture of Dorian Gray and The Importance of Being Earnest. So these were the popular works, popular plays that he wrote, which made him really famous throughout. Oscar Wilde's literary reputation rests largely on his novel, The Picture of Dorian Gray, that was written in 1891, and on his masterful comedies of manners, Lady Windermere's Fan, that was written in 1892, and The Importance of Being Earnest, which is written in 1895. So these were his works which made him really famous throughout the world, and he became a very famous playwright. Okay, moving ahead, let's now just understand what this particular story, that is The Happy Prince, is about. This story is an allegory. What's an allegory? It is a narration in which certain people, certain persons, the characters, the actions, they represent specific ideas or specific meaning. It conveys a particular meaning which deals with the human nature. The characters most of the time symbolizes real life human beings or figures. So it is based on the theme that love and sacrifice are important values in human life, and happiness comes to those who make others happy. So this is the basic theme of this particular story written by Oscar Wilde. Those who have compassion and concern get as much joy as those who receive their kindness and charity. So it's both ways. Those who give and those who take are satisfied. The story throws light on the problems of social inequality, the healing power of love, and the loss of innocence. So this is the major issues that are dealt with in this story. It is a story of a prince and a little swallow. The Happy Prince was a beautiful statue on the tall column in the city. He was initially a prince and then became a statue out here. A swallow takes shelter beneath this statue. The swallow bird and the statue of the prince sacrificed their happiness and wealth for the good of others. So in the entire story, you will see the prince and the swallow work towards the betterment of the people, for the good of the people in the city. So let's see what the story is. Before that, what are the main characters? Who are the main characters in the story? It is the Happy Prince. You can see the picture out here of the statue of the Happy Prince. He is a beautiful statue made of precious jewels, which parts with all its wealth to help the poor and the needy. So this is the prince. Then we have the swallow. It's a migrant bird who seeks shelter beneath the statue and sacrifices its life to help the prince in serving the poor and the needy. So how the swallow helps the prince, how the two of them together help the people of the city, we will see in this particular story. So let's begin, students. The happy prince was a beautiful statue. He was covered with gold. He had sapphires for eyes and a ruby in his sword. Why did he want to part with all the gold that he had and his precious stones? So what was the reason that he decided to part with all the wealth, all the jewels that he had? We'll understand in this particular lesson. High above the city, on a tall column, stood the statue of the happy prince. He was gilded all over with thin leaves of fine gold. For eyes, he had two bright sapphires, and a large red ruby glowed on his sword hilt. So this statue of the happy prince stood tall on the city column, okay? And he was gilded. Gilded meaning he was covered all over with thin leaves of fine gold. The eyes were made of bright sapphires, and a large red ruby glowed on the sword hilt. Sword hilt, hilt meaning the handle of the sword. It was covered with ruby. So much of precious stone was covered all over the statue of the happy prince. One night, there flew over the city a little swallow. His friends had gone away to Egypt 6 weeks before, but he had stayed behind. Then he decided to go to Egypt too. So one particular night, a swallow, a migrant bird, it flew to the city where this statue was placed. His friends, meaning the swallow's friends, the other mates, had gone away to Egypt. They had migrated to Egypt almost 6 weeks before. But he continued to stay out here. However, later on decided that he too would, the swallow would move to Egypt also, along with the, to join his friends out there. All day long he flew, and at night time he arrived at the city. So he flew throughout the day and at night arrived in this particular city. "Where shall I put up?" he said. "I hope the town has made preparations." So he was just thinking where he would halt for that particular night because he was tired. So he thought there must be some kind of preparations made in the town so that he could stay or halt in that particular city for the night. Then he saw the statue on the tall column. So he viewed, he could see that particular statue on that tall column of the city. "I will put up there," he cried. "It is a fine position with plenty of fresh air." So he alighted just between the feet of the happy prince. Okay, so he could see that statue. It was quite high up. So the swallow felt that he would stay there for the night because he would get plenty of fresh air high above out there. So he alighted, means he flew down and took his position between the feet of the happy prince. "I have a golden bedroom," he said softly to himself as he looked round, and he prepared to go to sleep. But just as he was putting his head under his wing, a large drop of water fell on him. So he was thinking to himself, he was having a beautiful golden bedroom because the statue was totally covered with gold and all kinds of precious stones and jewels. So he was thinking to himself that he has got a wonderful golden bedroom. And just as he was preparing to go to sleep, he saw that a large drop of water fell on him. So he was wondering where this large drop of water came from. What a curious thing, he cried. There is not a single cloud in the sky. The stars are quite clear and bright, and yet it is raining. So he was wondering that there was no clouds out there, no dark clouds in the sky. The stars were quite clear, they were shining brightly out there. But how is it that it is still raining? So he was finding it very curious. Then another drop fell. So there was one more drop which fell on the swallow. What is the use of a statue if it cannot keep the rain off? He said. I must look for a good chimney pot. And he determined to fly away. But before he had opened his wings, a third drop fell. And he looked up and saw. Ah, what did he see? So now he was thinking that if the statue could not help him or prevent him from the rain, so it is no use taking shelter out here beneath the statue. So he should look out for a chimney pot wherein he can be protected from the rain. So he decided to fly away searching for a chimney pot. But as he was trying to fly, a third drop of water fell on him. And when he looked up, he was shocked and stunned to see what he actually saw. He was wondering, what is this? So let's see what happened. The eyes of the happy prince were filled with tears, and tears were running down his golden cheeks. His face was so beautiful in the moonlight that the little swallow was filled with pity. So what did the swallow see? That the eyes of the happy prince, the statue of the happy prince, was filled with tears. The eyes were filled with tears. The tears were running down his golden cheeks. That is because he was covered totally with gold. Also, the face of the prince was glowing. It was looking so beautiful in the moonlight. The swallow really felt sorry for the prince as to why was he actually crying and why he had tears in his eyes. Who are you? He said. I am the happy prince. Why are you weeping then? Asked the swallow. You have quite drenched me. So the swallow was eager to know who this particular prince person was. So he replied stating that he was the happy prince and inquiring about why he was weeping. He also told the prince that he had almost drenched him with the tears. He was almost wet, totally wet with the tears that were flowing from the eyes. When I was alive and had a human heart, answered the statue. Now you can see the statue is now replying to the queries, the concern shown by the swallow. I did not know what tears were, for I lived in the palace where sorrow is not allowed to enter. My courtiers called me the happy prince. And happy indeed I was. So I lived and so I died. So what did he reply? That he used to stay in a huge palace where there was no place or no place for sorrow to enter. So he was not at all aware what tears were like. Also his courtiers used to always call him the happy prince because he was very happy getting whatever he needed. There was not a tear that he had shed. Also, he was really happy as he lived. And also when he died, he was very happy. He lived a very happy life. And now that I am dead, they have set me up here so high that I can see the ugliness and all the misery of my city. And though my heart is made of lead, yet I cannot choose but weep. So he continued saying that after his death, they made a huge statue out here and he is placed in this tall column in the city. He is so high, the statue is made so high that he could see the entire city. He was now able to see how miserable people were, what problems they were facing, what kind of issues they had in their lives. So he was really sorry about the state of affairs in the city. Also, though my heart is made of lead, his heart is now made of lead, he is not able to do anything but just weep, feel sorry and weep for his fellow men in the city. So this was the condition of the prince's mind, why he was crying. "What? Is he not solid gold?" said the swallow to himself. He was too polite to make any personal remarks. So he was fully made of gold, total solid gold. He was asking whether he was not made of solid gold and why is he weeping so much. However, he is not ready to give any kind of personal remarks about himself, talking about himself. He was too polite, too concerned about his fellow men of the city. "Far away," continued the statue in a low musical voice, "far away in a little street, there is a poor house." So now, as he was standing high up there, he was able to see all the miseries that were present in the city. So now he started narrating certain incidences, certain episodes in the city. So he says, "Far away in a little street, there is a poor house. One of the windows is open and through it I can see a woman seated at a table." So he is narrating to the swallow that he can see a woman seated near the table. The window is open and what is she doing? "Her face is thin and worn and she has coarse red hands." Thin and worn means she is very tired, very frail and thin. "She has coarse red hands. Her hands have become very rough, all pricked by the needle, for she is a seamstress." Okay? It's pricked by needle. Who is a seamstress? A female tailor is called a seamstress. Okay, so she keeps using the needle. So the needles have pricked her hands so much that it has turned red and it has become rough. So this happy prince is able to see this woman seated at the table and at work. "She is embroidering flowers on a satin gown for the loveliest of the queen's maids of honor to wear at the next court ball." So she is embroidering flowers. So embroidery takes a lot of pains to embroider a particular cloth. So she was embroidering flowers on a satin gown for the court ball. "In the bed in the corner of the room, her little boy is lying ill." So she is working, but in the corner of the room, her child, her little boy, is lying down ill, is very sick. So this the prince could see. "He has a fever and is asking his mother to give him oranges. His mother has nothing to give him but river water, so he is crying." So this child was down with high fever and he was asking his mother to give him some oranges to eat. But she was so poor that she couldn't afford this and she just gave him water, that is river water. So he's still crying because he wants to have oranges. "Swallow, swallow, little swallow, will you not bring her the ruby out of my sword hilt?" So now the prince is asking the swallow to help him. He tells the swallow that, "Take out the ruby from my sword hilt, the handle of my sword, so that I could give it to her." My feet are fastened to this pedestal and I cannot move. So he is requesting the swallow to take out the ruby as his own feet are fastened or stuck to the pedestal, that is a platform that is made, because of which he is not able to move. So he is asking the swallow to help him out. I am waited for in Egypt, said the swallow. My friends are flying up and down the Nile and talking to the large lotus flowers. Soon they will go to sleep. So here the swallow is replying that he has to go to Egypt very soon because his friends have already left. They are out there flying up and down the Nile and they will go to sleep if I don't reach on time. So he has to move to Egypt. The prince asked the swallow to stay with him for one night and be his messenger. So he requests, the prince requests the swallow that you stay with him for a night and be his messenger. Help him in what he wishes to do. The boy is so thirsty and the mother so sad, he said. So you need to help me in some way because the boy is really in a very bad state and the mother is also not very happy. I don't think I like boys, answered the swallow. I want to go to Egypt. But the happy prince looked so sad that the little swallow was sorry. So he answered saying that he really doesn't like boys, but however, seeing the happy prince's sad face, he decides that, okay, let me see, I may be a messenger for you. It is very cold here, he said. But he agreed to stay with him for one night and be his messenger. So he also told the prince that it's really cold here and he doesn't wish to continue staying here. However, he would stay for a night and be the happy prince's messenger. Thank you, little swallow, said the prince. The swallow picked out the great ruby from the prince's sword and flew away with it in his beak over the roofs of the town. He passed by the cathedral tower where the white marble angels were sculptured. So he thanked the swallow for agreeing to his wish. The swallow took the ruby from the prince's sword and started flying with it over the roofs of the town towards the seamstress who was in distress. He passed by the cathedral tower, that is a church tower, where the white marble angels, there were angels, the God, the messengers of God were sculpted in the church. He was seeing going through these towers. He passed by the palace and heard the sound of dancing. As he was passing the palace, he heard someone dancing. He could hear people dancing out there. A beautiful girl came out on the balcony with her lover. So the swallow saw that the girl, a beautiful girl, came out and was dancing along with her lover. I hope my dress will be ready in time for the state ball. So she was talking to her lover, stating that she had given a dress which needs to be worn for the state ball and she was wondering whether it was actually ready. I have ordered flowers to be embroidered on it, but the seamstresses are so lazy. So it was the gown that the seamstress was actually embroidering. So she was wondering, she exclaimed saying that the seamstresses in the city were very lazy. They don't do things on time. However, she was unaware of the problems that the seamstress was actually facing. She was actually getting the embroidery done on the dress. So what happens? So this was
overheard by the swallow, what he does, what the swallow does ahead. We will continue it in the next class. So go through the lesson, students. Whatever we have done so far, make a note of it. We'll continue the lesson in the next class. Now you will get a link where you have to answer the questions provided and submit the same on that particular link. Thank you.